favorite type of music?
I don't know, Anna.
Hip hop.
Very funny. Yep.
Hi everybody, thanks for coming. I'm Mr. Hathaway. That's more laughing than I've ever gotten out of any of those jokes that they've ever said, so thank you very much for supporting my wonderful students. So in front of you are the seventh grade class. We have three pieces that we're going to perform for you today. Our first piece is called Tribal Dance. That features, we have a couple of extra instruments in here. We have Agoski that's playing percussion for us for this, and then we have Jihu who's playing piano for us on this piece. After that, we're going to go ahead and do a medley of some Harry Potter music from The Goblet of Fire, which features Akshaya on the piano. And then we're going to close it out with a very exciting piece about woodland fairies called Dance of the Samadhi. I really hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. That's going to conclude the performance for the seventh graders. We're going to go ahead and take a quick break to do a set change to bring on the chamber ensemble. Thank you very much. Wonderful. All right, everybody. We're going to go ahead and continue along. The group that you see in front of you, this is the Chamber Ensemble. This is a club that I started many years ago at this school to kind of give an opportunity for students to go and pursue some more difficult music. Everybody here are high schoolers with a couple of eighth grade exceptions. They typically have been students that have been playing in my ensemble for many, many years. They've proven that they are up for the challenge for music, or whatever I decide to arrange for them. I like to arrange and compose, and this tends to be a good group for me to try stuff out on. So, we have three pieces that we're going to play for you tonight. We are going to start with one of my favorite Disney songs of all time, A Whole New World from Aladdin. We are going to go ahead and continue along with an arrangement of Rachmaninoff's Vocalise, arranged for string orchestra. And then we are going to finish off with an arrangement of Movement 4 from Felix Mendelssohn's Symphony. I really hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
There we go. Sorry, my microphone's dying. Just going to go ahead and say a couple more things while my next group's getting ready. I just wanted to thank everybody, of course, for coming out again. Well, I did make one mistake, and I just want to make sure I rectify it. I left one name out of the program, and he probably didn't want me to mention this, but it was William Chu, who, of course, is a wonderful clarinet player, and I just want to make sure that I give him the appreciation that he deserves. This is our last piece for the Chamber Ensemble. This is Symphony No. 5, the Reformation Movement from Felix Mendelssohn. Thank you. Leg of our concert here. This is my 8th grade class. It's a combination of 8th grade students and 9th grade students. It's actually for all high school students, but it just so happens that I have only 8th and 9th grade students, I'm pretty sure, right? Which is great. I had a lot of these students from last year. We have some new folks in here too who are just barely learning their instrument, but they did such a great job. They have a lot of really great pieces for you first night. We're going to be starting with one of my all-time favorite melodies, Waltz of the Flowers from Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker. Then we're going to move on to greatest blues musician of all time, Johann Sebastian Bach. We're going to go ahead and play some Sleeper's Wake for you. Then we're going to move on to two more modern pieces. The next piece, another waltz, a little bit of a spookier waltz called Skeleton Waltz, where they'll be using some extended techniques on their instrument that you'll see. And then we'll be ending strong with a very daring and adventurous piece called Enigma. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
things up. Your students will meet you back here in the gym as soon as they got all their things and they're ready to go. I hope you have a great 3-day weekend. See you next time.